Hi, this is Lakshmi Kantiwari. Welcome back to your new tutorial. So as you know, we are designing app compat edit text layout and app compat edit text. So we are done with our layout. Now we are going to do some programming into our Java main activity.java file. So first of all, that we need to create the object here for our edit layout as well as edit text. So first of all, that we want our app compat, okay, app compat edit text, and for username as username, and then password, right? And then we want reference for the object for our text input layout. So what we need to do here, we can simply type here, you know, the text input layout, okay. So the text input layout, and then we want here user layout, okay, and then there is password layout, right? So you see here the app compat edit text, this reference is for this one, and the text input layout reference is for this one, right? Okay, great. So now we are done with these two declaration. Now we want a reference. So let's do the referencing from here after the toggle sync state, right? So first we want a reference for our username. So let's do for the username. Username is equal to app compat edit text, and then find v by id, then r dot id dot, you can say the username text field, and then we want for password similarly, and the password is app compat edit text, and then find v by id, then r dot id dot password text field, right? And the similarly we want, you know, the user layout is equal to, you know, that's the text input layout, right? The text input layout, and then find v by id, then r dot id dot username text input layout, right? And the similarly we want for the password. So the password layout is equal to text input layout, and then find v by id, then r dot id dot, you know, here is the password text input layout, right? So we have got the reference for username, password, user layout, and the password layout, right? Now I am going to set here the character counter, right? So what I can do here, so let's first the user layout dot set counter enable, right? So set counter enable, make it the true, and inside the user layout dot set counter max length. So I'm gonna put max length, that's the 12. That's mean nobody can put more than the 12 character, otherwise the error would be shown there, right? And for the password similarly, password dot layout, and then set the counter enable, that's I'm gonna make it the true, and then the password layout dot set counter max length, right? So I'm gonna make it as let's say the 16 character password, right? Now let's run it, and then I'll show you what I am telling you here. Great. So let it open this one. See here, the character max length max is 12, and now the zero character is there. Now let me enter here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 11, 12, 13, 14. See there, the color has been changed. 12, 13, 12, 13. See, that's when there is something wrong there. Okay. Fine, and same thing can would happen here in the password. If I enter more than 16 characters, see there, more than the 16 characters, how the color is being changed there. Right, now let's add some more functionalities. Now I'm gonna show you how you can perform, you know, if you enter anything into the text view in Google or anywhere, on means after entering every character, I mean on the change of every character, some suggestions popped out, right? So the same thing you can implement here. I mean you can attach here the character change listener. So if you change anything inside these two text view, then there would be a listener which will execute, right? So what we can do here, we can go with username dot, you know, dot, sorry, add text changed listener, right? Then you can see here new text watcher, right? See here a lot of code has been automatically came out, such as the before text change and the on text change and the after text change. So what I want to do here, I want to check if the character is empty. I mean I want to check if this this field is empty, then it must show some error, right? So let's see the on character changed. So on character changed, what I'm gonna do, if you know, I'm gonna take the username dot get text, I'm going to convert into the two string, and I'm going to see if it is empty, right? So if it is empty, then it must show some error, right? So inside the user layout dot set error enable, that's the true, okay? And then again the user layout dot set error, and I'm gonna type here please enter your user name, right? And if field is not empty, then of course it is going to disable the error. So the user layout dot set error, the user layout dot set error enable, that will be a false, right? So let's run it and check it, then you will understand what I am trying to say here. Perfect. See, now the username is focused. Now if I press on the password, okay, let's enter some character here, see there, right? So the please enter your username, right? So the please enter your username, but as you had noticed there, let me show you one more time, then you will realize, right? See here, the still, I mean the field is empty, but it is not showing anything. Even I am changing the focus, but it is not showing anything. That means there is something still we need to do. That's the on focus change. So we need to add one more listener here, that is on focus changed, right? So once we change the focus, then it will check the total number of character inside the username, and according to that, then again it will perform some action. So for that, what we need to do, we need to do again a username dot set on focus change listener, right? And then of course you can say the new on focus change listener, okay? Then it will automatically add a set of code and override method, that's the on focus change. And inside the on focus change, we need to add this same code, okay? So just copy this code and paste this code here, right? So now let's run it and I'll show you what is happening there. while it is installing and building the gradles, I would like to tell you one more thing. So here I have done this for only the username, but for the practice, if you want, you can also do a practice with your password field also. Okay, so before I install, before I stop this tutorial, I'll show you only my emulator. Okay, so if I change here my focus, see, please enter the username, right? But earlier it was not there. Now if I press the on outside, but error is still there, right? See here, right? So once I focus it, I have to enter something there, right? Perfect. Now I think I have covered many things for app compat edit text and text input layout. So in the next tutorial, I'll be covering material buttons, in which I'll be showing you three different type of buttons: raised button, flat button, and floating buttons, and then the menu of a floating button. So these tutorials are going to be really very interesting. So you can subscribe this channel so that you can get directly update into your inbox. So thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned for the next one. Bye bye. Have a nice day.